He's already been started. Tuskar. He's got Blink Dagger available. The Dream Call over on three. GPK will begin this with the orbs flying forwards. A lot of damage. Song of the Siren. Everybody think about this. Where's Disruptor? Where's the Storm? He's TPing out. It's going to take too long. The Snowball's there. Snowballing in towards Roshan. Now the Storm comes out. Who gets caught? It's Limp as well as 33. No ability to split. He had it available as well, but totally silenced up. Now GPK gets the instant bash onto the Viper. So Nika baby down as well. 33 is bought back. You've got that Brewmaster split ready to go. Echo Slam jumps forward to the Life Sealer. He might be able to toggle this if he can just get himself away from the stuns. The Fissure, they're too far away. Snowball forward, stunning up onto one, and get back over here, Lim. Glimpse in to the wall, and Alliance, their back is up against it. Gambit will go into Roshan. Alliance committed so much, and with four heroes dead, they will lose Roshan to Gambit. They've lost the fight. And this game's gonna swing. This game's gonna swing hard. Very, very quickly. So the ability just to push high ground can come with the cost. Like GPK is doing his push on bottom lane, trying to work his way all the way into the Daedalus. You've got Morphling, who has the two waveform challenges. So one waveform, he basically cleans the wave anyway. And they look towards the top, Blink in. He goes for the Horse Stomp and the Doom over on the Anti-Mage. A quick Savage Roar as well. But yeah, it's the Aegis Seymour. They're able to break through. FNG gets an extra hold. He's staying there, waiting for a huge overgrowth. He needs him to come back up again. The Bear is waiting, and now's your time. FNG's waiting for it. Is he going to finally let rip? There's four heroes. He's able to get three of them out. There's one, 33. Instantly shotgun down. The Doombringer will die, but he's already in his job. Buyback comes in for Legion Commander Dream, waveforms himself away, and they bring down Nico, baby. 2 minutes on the sidelines. Limp cannot create enough space with this avalanche. He will consume the cheese, but he will not be able to survive this, even with that consumption.
The Blood Rise silence on Desire Matu. See if Fiji can step in the pit in time. Roche is fully in leather. They've got the Fenner Ward in, so they know the time. They're going to jump in, look for the steal. Dire takes the road for Ramzes. He snatches the Aegis. They will lose crit immediately. Arbeb will be able to blink out in time. Bloodbright is going to finish offside by the looks of it. It will. Arteezy takes the kill on Beastmaster. Matu's diving in. He's looking for the backline, but Arbeb, he can turn, forcing Matu to time lapse. They'll pop the Aegis on Ramzes. So Secret do push EG back, but EG able to get away with that Aegis steal. Ramzes, he's still not done yet. The silence clips onto Nisha. He has to TP out to safety. That's going to get the space for the diver for more. Ramzes, Ravage on two. It gets the big one. It gets Matu, and it clears up mid one as well as EG now. Ice Blast isn't going to connect, though. And in fact, Grim, he's going to look to commit. He's straight in with the Doom onto Nisha. Arbez there with the follow-up jumps in. Ravage from Ramzes. He gets all four of them. It's perfect. EG destroying Secret, and Zion Puppy will fall. Matu surrounded. He's the only one left alive. He did buy back. He's gone for 90. EG destroy Secret.
Diet's chasing down Resolution here, does get some damage, and maybe this is the turnaround that no one was looking for. Resolution actually survives, gets off the Firestorm with the Coil on top of two. It's looking really good, but had to be able to jump away, and Crystallize tries to chase him, but saved. Beautiful kinetic field. Now no one is healed up. He comes back in with that double damage.
He's getting him.
He's healed just enough to be able to get the kill on Crystallize. Now looks for Zayats as well. Hops over the trees, gets the triple kill. Trent, you called it. You said no one is going to look for Na'Vi to overextend, and he will punish. And he does exactly that. Perfectly glimpse away. Magical. Not going to be able to get the kill on a
save. Can I see an ultra?
An ultra kill for no one. With the double damage, it's looking pretty good so far. Two-man coil. Magical. He's going to break his. And Crystallize will stand and fight. Coil's gonna break out here. They've already stolen a lot of damage away from this Medusa. And with the Doom onto no one, this is exactly what they wanted. They're able to focus on a hero that wasn't the Aegis. Fortunately,
that's huge.
That Dark Rift actually got everybody out.
No, that was the Aegis died.
He actually killed Epileptic Kid, and so now he's stuck without a home. His Zayat's gonna be able to stop that TP. What a massive turnaround for Na'Vi. Epileptic Kid, can he get a kill out of this one? It looks like the Lich is gonna die as he stares a little bit too long into the eyes of the Medusa, but still, a massive kill. 500 gold for Crystallize as a mega kill streak is ended.
ES still not rejoining the fight just yet, the Hex. Not able to really capitalize thanks to the avalanche mini stuns of the VG Gaming. Gabby looking for another run in. He's in his BKB ready to go. But man, that Hex looking to go to work once more. He's doppelganger away. Gabby is so low, tries to dodge at least the damage from Urus. But Gabby, this BKB, spent all the time just running away, running back over towards Tim. Another doppelganger. He actually can survive. Urus couldn't put him in the grave just yet. A lot of damage being taken as VG, the adaptive strike from Urus, able to reach Gabby. And Yang has joined the fight too. The stun onto Tim. The shark Timer's gonna be a little bit late. Another avalanche hit all five players. Well, by Tim's, no more time to get back out. His buyback is available. The tier 3 tower will drop.
You'll die before you kill that guy.
They're coming again. They're breaking the Slark, at least with a Viper swap out of Morphling. Abaddon's still on the front lines, fighting underneath this Nether Toxin. Waveform forward, a lot of damage. Urus, now Gabby, into the BKB. Urus, he'll go into the Shadow Dance, knowing he can just hide in the Invis and try and finish the job. They still haven't claimed the melee racks in a bash. Brewmaster, he's gonna go down. Morphling doesn't have a lot of life either. Gabby's gone all the way back to base to heal up. Salving as quickly as he possibly can with a Thunderstrike. It actually reached it.
Wait, what?
Gabby died to a Thunderstrike of Disruptor right inside the base. Down is the Morphling. You have to think about buying back. You'll do so with the Brewmaster. Armel fighting on the front lines. The Pulse Nova doing all the damage to kill up the VS. Then you killed up VS. That's a double-edged sword. Good overgrowth. A little bit more time to control. Gabby able to get the stun damage into the Abaddon. But the issue is still going to be the fact that Slark is getting bigger and bigger as these fights continue to force. Can't get Morphling!
Getting punished a lot by the Treant and that Viper. So now he just has to hit the jungle, let his team run around and look to make those plays as we saw in that last game. Lots of rotations coming down. We have outposts.
It's that 10-minute time. Gambit, certainly winning a fight. Crit's gonna get the toss back straight into the Requiem. That's the combo. Abed blows a Vampire. It's a big hero to lose. They relied on Vampire's Overgrowth a lot to try and take earlier fights, but now he's gone. Shashlo's trapped in by the kinetic field. EG clean up the two kills.
Alliance, and they don't really need to do a whole lot here. They can play defensively on their high ground as Solo runs into them.
They've seen this play before, though. They kind of know what he's trying to do.
Virtus Pro is not hiding it whatsoever. Alliance, 20 seconds until the RP. That's why Virtus Pro is rushing this so much. Bloodright, as well as the Shivas. Now the BKB activated. They're going to go for Epileptic Hit, but he's going to try and finish up this Roshan. Nice telekinesis stopping the skewer in from Limp, but Solo's already dead. Roshan's Aegis picked up by no one. He's going to be able to get off his ultimate as well. Veering back some of these heroes, including Fada, who's probably going to be dying
two seconds
RP, 33 though. Up in the air. And Nico Baby actually choosing to come back in. His Resolution's going to lose his Panda. He dies. Limp's in with the RP as well. Nico Baby is tearing it up a storm here as GG is called. He doesn't even wait for a second life. Him and Epileptic Kid, they're both alive, but they say we have been destroyed by Alliance. That's three fights in a row, and that's just game.
Trying to take that outpost back.
Do they know just... they didn't remove the bottom outpost? It was just the shrines? We're still just fighting over this one.
The toss up in the air. The Brewmaster is going to get chainsawed a little bit, but he does have a primal split. Not in fear of being nuked down. He's going to be able to get it off now. And Turnstar's Resolution, who's also been ruptured. Also, Limp's going to jump onto him, knocked up in the air, and there goes the Doom. They're going to be able to kill the Crystal Maiden as well. It looks like old Tiny, he's going to be chased down as Nico Baby, running all these heroes down. Going to be able to finish off one of the cores. Epileptic Kid, he's going to be next up on the dock. And Gyrocopter, he's going to fall as well. Vada's not dead yet. He's taking a little bit, and the Radiant will finally finish him off, but that's 1-4.
Beautifully done.
Team Secret, they are on the way. Wave of Terror gives a good reveal, looking for a good Shackle as well, unable to connect. VG Gaming leaving the pit for Tumberman. That's a good E-Blade pop onto the Viper, an even better Shackle. Troll, Omni-Knight locked together. The Stomp, the Sleep is buying some more time. Now the GA's back up, the ET Splitter. Team Secret, their ears are ringing, but Viper is down. Windranger still battling from the side inside of Roshan. The focus fire did the work. PYW tried to get there in time for his own stuns, but it just didn't do anywhere near enough. BS, the only one to die, but that's the one Team Secret want to die. Yang on the wrong side of the river. And Team Secret will thank VG for their hard work dropping Roshan down. Tiny, oh, YOLO play, the snowball forward is a lot of damage, but Roshan's not dead. Now it's going to be Tiny the one to die. Roshan to be claimed too.
So really seeing the game plan come into fruition here.
Does Timber buy back? Urus is here, he's gonna plant the field, do some damage inside the pit, but Tiny tosses him up, tries to trap him, but BKB from Urus, looking to steal the damage. There's so much damage in towards Zai, he's trying to jump himself out in time, back towards the shrine. They're healing up, but Viper won't be so lucky. And Tumberman left behind, he just get bashed up by Roshan, he get locked in, VG, Zai, no, he couldn't steal it. He tried to get in and actually grab the Aegis the Immortal, but Radiant have already taken everything. The Aegis in the hands of Urus.
And instant Limp.
They've got the Doom dropped down. Limp's in trouble. Burst out the hook straight away. Cannot be there as 33 just falling low on the front lines. The homing missile burst him down. Ori's diving in, forcing Nico Baby to retreat. as Alliance just have to back off again. They lose two cores. Vici Gaming, they don't lose anything.
As we'll have outposts in about 45, and Yuris, he's just in.
He is. He tried for Hanscan. He's going to get dragged back here. Gets the Shadow Dance off in time. He's still trying to commit onto the Scarab Maze. Trying to kill him off Demic Hard. The drag back with the RP. Finally forced forward. Yuris will finish off Hanscan and out to try and turn for more Ori. Throwing out the Chakram. Forcing 33 back. The Silence there onto Limp. Limp's tanky, but they're slowly peeling him down. BKB comes out from Limp. Buyback from DY. Vici Gaming wants to commit heavily for this fight.
Oh, the pet's over.
He's forced to BKB. Fada looks to glimpse back. Yuris will be able to take him away. But Ori commits, gets the kill. Nico Baby has to BKB TP out. Alliance know this is not a fight to take.
Suppose the combo is now gone, but it feels like as this game drags on, there's that bigger chance that you just have that big late game fight that just messes you up. But they'll try and force the issue now. No longer waiting. Darkseer does have buyback available thanks to Tier 1 tower dropping, so he's got the money. The man Gambit, they're not even defending. Like, no one's coming to this. The TB's coming in from Naga, Song of the Siren now gonna come out. Darkseer buys back.
Here it goes, Toby.
FNG's prepared for the wall and Storm, able to get both of them off with the back and the wall. Snowball keeping the AoE stun going. Templar Assassin dropping very quickly, but then again, eating the damage. The Shrek doesn't care. Where was your damage? Where was your life? Where was your hope, Gambit? Yuris just goes ham, triggering the Bloodstone charge, gives himself a triple kill. That was the combination from Gambit that was meant to hit hard, but BG Gaming, they're just so much better. Pumping into FNG, they do not want that Borrowed Time triggered already. Quick read on the Nightstalker, toss forward, there's that Borrowed Time trigger. Raw over on the Tiny, who does Gambit really go on? The Torrent combination, that they're ready for it. Dream under the cover of BKB, just not doing enough. He has those damage over on Yuris, now he's able to do that. Yuris is dropping very, very quickly. Dream needs a little bit more time, but the ships, they just keep on hitting down as well with the Avalanche toss combo. Yang gets himself a double kill. The Dream call of the puck, the work is now being done, but he's silenced up. He cannot phase ships out, he has to wait it out. Drone Ranger back to life thanks to Aegis Immortal. FNG putting his open into a horn to work. But they have to get back in without the Morphling Gambit. It's all or nothing now. But Nightstalker diving in deep. A triple kill for Yang. Drone Ranger ready to fight once more. Ripping through the Abaddon. Puck still with Arabia playing the back line for the Avalanche. Toss, combo, silence. That'll be the game right there. He'll face it, but the GG is called. VG Gaming will 2-0 Gambit.
Just too much, man.
Start a fight, and with how big Abed is, they may even be able to hold their own on this. Can Vici blow him up in time? They'll get the lift up, drag him back, BKB's out, Abed
he's dropping!
He's dying, the Living Armor will not save him, they get the big kill, but now EG, they're bringing in the numbers, the curse is there, DY holds back EG, can Vici Gaming continue to turn? It's the multi-shot, it's cutting them low, Ramses will fall, no whoa, chance for a heal, BKB's popped by Artizi, he's got to get out of there, because Fly dies also. Vici Gaming take the fight, and they're not done yet. They're hunting in the trees, seeing if they can find Crit. Crit trying to do his best to juke them out. Yang, he found him, gets the slow off, glimpse back, will be in place. But Yuris shoots out with another barrage of arrows. Vici Gaming take four. It's ended in disaster for Vici.
They're scanning though, they're looking.
Yuris, he's in with the vision. They'll get the drag back on fly. Look for the squishy kill first. Art's easy. Starting to see if he can feel confident even without the ult. He's eyeing him up. Arbed's going to go in with the static link. He can commit as well with the Iron Storm if he wishes to do so.
They're big avalanche.
On. They're on top of them. The static storm down. Though Arteezy is silenced. They turn on the void. Arteezy, he's dead.
Oh my
he
god.
He overextends. So does Arbed. Drag back's there. They're not in yet. Vici Gaming. They'll grab in Crit. Crit's going to get run down. He'll turn with the toss in the avalanche. Try and bring down someone with it. But the purification heals up DY. Triple kill for the Elder Titan. They're going to have one last. Shots.
168 agility right now on this Slark. He's taking the buildings very fast.
And they're fighting into this Yuris Aegis. It seems impossible for EG here as they start to build towards their final stand. He's in.
Chrono.
He does catch Yuris on the side. The GA's out. Can Arteezy get the kills in time? He's trying for the disruptor, but he doesn't have the damage. Yuris, he's in with Shadow Dance. He'll go towards Ramses. Can they get the Enigma away? Ramses healed up, but it hasn't gone. But Yuris finishes him off. Ramses is dead. Arbed is gone. Arteezy left alone with Fly. He'll go back towards the fountain, but the fish is waiting for him. GG is called. Ladies and gentlemen,
FG Gaming take the match, and with that take the series 3-0. Your one Esports Dota 2 World Pro Invitational champions are FG Gaming, and they do not drop a single map here.